Recently, I came across this new software center application specifically designed for Flatpaks. I liked the idea and thought of sharing it with you folks. The app is called Bazaar, which means market. An appropriate name as it is somewhat like a marketplace where you can shop for new applications. By shop, I mean you can search for new Flatpak applications and install them from there. Just wanted to clarify that. Don't take my joke seriously. You can see the resemblance between GNOME Software Center and Bazaar. Clearly, this app is primarily built for GNOME, but there is a KRunner plugin available for KDE Plasma desktop users too. It is straightforward to use. You can find some suggested apps on the storefront, and you can also look into the categories and see the apps listed in there. Clicking on an application shows more details about it. There are screenshots to look at, and then there is download size, license information, and download statistics as well. Clicking on the download statistics gives you a chart view and a map view. The map view shows the downloads per region for that application. Another interesting feature is that if an application has add-ons, you can use Bazaar to install them as well. Frankly, I'm not surprised with these features. All this is coming from Flathub website itself. Bazaar is essentially a front end for Flathub, but it also supports other Flatpak repositories. For example, if I add elementary Flatpak repository, it will increase the total number of available Flatpaks in Bazaar applications. Bazaar also has an interesting Easter egg that pokes fun on Flatpak sizes, perhaps. I am sure this one is not coming from Flathub. Clicking on the download size gives you funny statistics. Useless, but funny. Seems like my sense of humor matches with the developers. Alright, apart from browsing for applications, you can also search for them. Hit the install button to install your selected application, and you can see a progress bar on the top right. Click on it, and it opens the entire progress bar as a sidebar. It also shows the items and runtimes as they are installed. Now, this progress bar can be customized, and I have a feeling that not everyone is going to like it, especially in these times. In the preferences, you can change the accent color to Pride Rainbow Flag or Lesbian Pride Flag or Non-Binary Flag, etc. Frankly, I was not aware that there were so many subcategories and flags under LGBTQ. I only knew about the rainbow one. There is a category for aromantic people as well. Good that my wife doesn't know about it, else she will set this flag up for me. You can also see the Flatpaks installed on your system in Bazaar and remove them from there. It just takes a simple click. There are a few more features here and there. Like, you could choose to only display free applications. Free means free as in freedom, not free as in free beer. In other words, only display open source software, not proprietary ones like Discord, Spotify, etc. You will also notice a curated tab, which is not clickable at all. This can be configured by distributions to give their users a more localized experience and thus spotlighting Flatpak software which may be of specific interest. Overall, this is an interesting app store for Flatpak lovers. It is not perfect, of course. I would like to see the option to filter the applications by remote repositories or even option to favorite your apps or exporting a list of installed Flatpaks that can be later imported in Bazaar on another system. This will help get more practical uses for end users like me and you. I let you explore Bazaar and share your experience and views in the comment section. And I'll see you in the next video.